Let's talk a little bit about this. I have to say, after listening to Daniel O'Day this morning, I felt pretty good about prospects, thinking that some of these treatments could really be the bridge to when we get a vaccine. And I was impressed by what he said about these results. What do you think?
Yeah, I think the results were strong. They confirm what we knew, which is remdesivir is active in this disease. It's not a home run drug. It's a weekly active antiviral, but it has a treatment effect. So it's meaningful. I think combined with the antibody drugs, which should be coming on the market soon based on the data that we've seen, this is a pretty effective treatment regimen in advance of a vaccine. The challenge is going to be that we don't have enough doses of these antibody-based drugs. We foresaw this problem. We've talked about it many times in this show. We should have, Lilly will have about 1 million doses between now and the end of the year. Regeneron could have up to 300,000 doses between now and the end of the year. But my estimate is that we would need probably 12,000 to 15,000 doses a day just to take care of the population over the age of 65. And that assumes that the epidemic doesn't get any worse. And that doesn't bake in all the other people who are at high risk of bad outcomes who would want to have access to this drug. So we're going to be supply constrained, unfortunately, between now and the end of the year.
That's with the antibody cocktails that you were talking
right.
about. But I was impressed when remdesivir, actually, they're going to have dosage enough. That's what Daniel O'Day said, is that they'll have enough dosage for anybody who needs it, not only in the United States, but throughout the world in the not-too-distant future.
Yeah, they did an extraordinary job ramping up their supply because this was a very difficult product to make, and they managed to innovate the manufacturing process as well to really compress the timeline that it took to manufacture this drug. I think when they started, it was a 9-month process to make this drug. So they invested very heavily in manufacturing, partnered with other companies. So it's quite an achievement. I think the combination of remdesivir with the antibody drugs, which should be synergistic, we're going to have to study that. We don't have research on that yet, but there's no reason to believe that it shouldn't be synergistic. And that's the combination that the president got as well. That combination should be effective. And so we should continue to see death come down, mortality come down with COVID in the hospital, in hospitalized patients with the combination of these two drugs as they make their way into the marketplace. People are getting remdesivir right now. It's standard of care. But the antibodies, I think, will provide another important therapeutic option. And the other thing to keep in mind with the antibodies, and unfortunately we're not going to have a lot of supply to really use them this way, but they could potentially be very effective as a prophylaxis, so almost as a vaccine. You'd probably have to redose someone every month, but it should be protective. That's what we've seen with antibody drugs used in a similar fashion with the Ebola virus.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.